What's up, everyone? Welcome back to my channel. If you guys are new here, my name is Lisa, and today I am back with another current Mejuri favorites. So I've done two videos so far. I have the first one here and the second one here, and you guys seem to absolutely love the videos. I've been updating you guys on my collection as I go, and I feel like I've been doing it every 3 or 4 months or so. This is probably the longest I've waited to make another video, so it's been 6 months now. If you guys don't know, I actually review a couple of Mejuri products every single month. So make sure you follow along and click subscribe so you guys can see the new items that I collect on a monthly basis. But if you guys didn't know, I am one of Mejuri's biggest fans, and I feel like I have so many products from them, and I get so many questions about what each product is and how I like it. In fact, my entire hand is all decked out in Mejuri. My friends actually make fun of me, and they're just like, there's literally a Mejuri store on your hand. Every time I see them, like, some people will try certain rings on if they're interested. But anyway, today is gonna be the updated collection, and as usual, I have 10% off with Mejuri. You guys can use the link down below. No code needed, you just need to click on it, and it will apply for all of the Mejuri products that I mentioned in today's video or any other products that you're interested in. So anyway, just like the previous two videos, I'm gonna go through my updated collection and must-haves for each category. Also, I'm gonna go into my wish list at the end of the video, and you guys can try out some new products with me. Without further ado, let's get started. First category that I'm gonna go through are earrings. I actually realized that this time round I collected a lot of earrings from Mejuri. So the first earring that I want to talk about is one that I am wearing right now, and the reason why I wanted to talk about it first is because this is the pair of earrings that I got the most questions on Instagram. Every time I post a story about these earrings, I always get a DM about, like, oh my god, what are those earrings? What are they called? Where are they from? Etc. It is the Mejuri Threader, and I purposely only put on one so I can also hold it up to show you guys right now. But basically what the threader is, it has this anchor kind of at the beginning for you to poke through your hole. There's this stud at the very end for you guys to kind of anchor the earring. The reason why these threaders are my absolute favorite is because of two reasons. Number one, you can wear it in so many different ways. The first way is you can just wear it on one hole and you can dangle it. You can wear it just dangling like this. You can even wear it halfway so it dangles kind of like from here. And then the last way, which is my favorite way to wear it, is actually looping through both holes. So I feel like if you have more than one earring hole, this looks super dainty and just so amazing. I get so many questions when I wear it like this. And another thing I really like about it, which I actually mentioned in my how to start a jewelry collection video, which you can also check out here. These earrings, if you guys are just looking for kind of like a stopper, like let's just say you don't necessarily want to have earrings on all the time, but you don't want to have studs because sometimes it collects the gross pus at the end with the studs, with the backing. This is such a relaxed way of wearing earrings that look good, that stay on forever because they're solid gold. You don't ever have to take it off. It's super breathable because there's absolutely no backing, so you can honestly wear it almost like an earring stopper. And if you guys don't know what that is, it's basically just like this little piece of thing that just like prevents your holes from closing up. So I actually like this also as kind of like a stopper style. It's super comfortable. I don't feel anything when I sleep, and it's just so versatile. I know that was a long time, but let's go on to the next item. So the next set of earrings are the Harris Bold Chain. This is what it looks like. They are also solid gold. You can also wear it in versatile ways. As you guys can see, these are my favorite type of earrings. Like, I love buying one product that has multiple uses because you're getting so much more bang for your buck. It's like almost as though you're buying two items. I really like this because you can wear it obviously like dangling like this, or you can also just kind of like hoop the earring in the back and clip it like this and wear it as so. I'm not gonna lie to you, that picture on Mejuri's website where they wore it like with the little hoop at the end was what sold me. When I saw that picture, I was like, I must have these earrings. Anyway, this is what the earrings look like, and they're solid gold as usual, so you never have to take it off. Okay, so the third pair of earrings that I want to share with you are the diamond pave studs. So these are the circular studs with diamond on them. As you guys can see, starting from the second Mejuri video, I'm already starting to transition to have more diamond pieces for myself, because let's be real, if you guys follow me, you guys will already know that I'm single. So if I'm gonna be waiting for a man to give me earrings, like, let's be real, I'm probably gonna be like 40. So you know what? I have given up and I have just decided to start collecting my own diamonds, okay? And getting it for my damn self. So I just am not gonna wait for no man anymore. So starting with last month, I already got a ring and also my initial pendant that are diamonds, but this time I have so many more diamond stuff that I can't wait to show you guys. So starting with these earrings, I just absolutely love them because they're super simple and it's such a great introduction to diamonds. It's just pave diamonds. So what that is just little smaller diamonds instead of one large chunk of diamonds. So I feel like it's a really good introductory for me personally until I can start to afford, and also if I feel like I deserve like a larger chunk of diamond. Okay, so the next earring that I have for you are the editor hoops, and I have it on my other ear because I just wanted to show you guys what it looks like. But the editor hoops are gold vermeil, and as I mentioned in how to start a jewelry collections video, it is such a great introductory earring, especially if you don't like to wear hoops at night. These are probably the best-selling Mejuri earrings on their website that are gold vermeil. They just look so good. You can see all these bloggers styling it. These are probably like the hoop earrings that you need if you don't have any hoop earrings. If you are looking for that one staple hoop earring that goes with everything, this is literally the hoop earring. I'm not even joking you. It is at such a good price point. Like I said, because it's gold vermeil, you do have to take it off at night. You can't wear it all the time. I don't know if you would want to because it is a little bit thicker. I highly recommend these earrings. Okay, so the next earring that is kind of relatively in the same size, I'm just gonna show you, they are actually pretty much identical in terms of the largeness, are the large hoops. And I actually mentioned this in previous Mejuri must have videos that this was on my wish list, and I literally mentioned this so many times, but I saw that one picture on Mejuri's website as usual where it kind of like stacks along the ear. It has the large one, the between ones, and the small ones. So I just had that look basically like engraved in my brain, and I've been wanting that look for so long. I finally was able to achieve it by getting the large ones because I had the between hoops from a long time ago, as you guys may have seen already from my previous must-have video. But I was waiting for the large ones to come in, and they look so good when you stack it together. And now that stores are starting to open up, I'm also waiting for a third piercing so I can get the small one. That way I can have my whole look put together that I've been visualizing for over 2 years now. I also want to say that the large hoops, unlike the editor hoops, these are solid gold. If you guys are like, okay, but it's kind of large, like, I don't know if I'm gonna sleep with them, let me tell you, I have been sleeping with them for the last week. So I've only actually changed into these earrings because I was filming them and showing you guys what it looks like. This month, actually, for the entire month of like almost May and June, I've been wearing them and wearing it to sleep, and it's been fine. It hasn't lost shape at all. The first night was a little bit weird for me, just out of sheer laziness and living on my own. I cannot be bothered putting on jewelry on and off all the time by myself. Like, I just don't have the patience for that. Honestly, like, my fingers can't move like that all the time. I personally like to leave it on. If you are also a lazy person like I am, this is just good news for you because we don't got to take it off. So there you have it. Okay, so moving on to necklaces. The first necklace that I want to talk to you guys about is the Diamond Station necklace that I am wearing right now. I have paired it with the initial diamond pendant, as you guys have seen from the second Mejuri must-haves video. These two together, you guys, it is so, so, so beautiful. Like, I even raved about this all over my Instagram stories. I just kept on going like, oh my god, this combination is elite. You do not obviously have to get both, but the two together, for me, it's one of those combos where I wear it and I'm just like, I'm literally better than you. I am so confident when I say this because when I wear this, I'm just like, I feel like I'm on top of the world. Anyway, the other thing functionally that I really like about this necklace is that when I wear the Diamond Station necklace on its own, it kind of goes backwards and I see the back of the necklace. So when I kind of anchor it down with the initial pendant, it actually does kind of like anchor it down, and it just has such a cute, dainty diamond look. It really, really, really elevates your style and just kind of like makes you look expensive. If you're kind of like starting to get into diamonds. Like, I highly recommend this combo because it just looks so, so, so cute together. Also, I forgot to mention, for the Diamond Station necklace, it is solid gold, so you literally never have to take it off. I never take off this combo, at least until I'm like transitioning and changing up my necklace combinations, but otherwise I don't really take it off. I just love low maintenance jewelry. That's another perk to this necklace. Okay, so the next necklace that I have for you guys is a gold vermeil necklace, and this one is another statement necklace. So the one that I have is the bold initial pendant, and this is what it looks like. I just have it in L. I'm just like laughing because I have so many initial products from Mejuri. Like, you would think that I'm about to forget my name or something. Like, I need help. Like, what is my name? Oh, there's definitely a W in here. And now I got this one in the L. Basically, this is the necklace that I feel like, if you guys have followed me from a really, really long time ago, I have always loved my Zodiac necklace from Mejuri. It is about the length, okay? Not every single outfit that you wear is gonna be about this neck length when you are wearing like a top. Sometimes you'll wear, you know, tops that go all the way up to your neck, and you really want like that big statement piece in the middle of your shirt. Or even like if you have like a lower cut shirt, you kind of want the eyes to draw kind of a little bit lower and not just like having that awkward negative space on your chest. Maybe if you have cleavage, it wouldn't be negative space, but I can't relate. So for me, it's negative space. Point is, I always find myself in that situation a lot. In the past, I've always worn my Zodiac necklace, and now I've upgraded it to this one. The pattern is so beautiful. I've complained about this before. I don't love the structure of L and how it looks for the initial. If you guys have funner looking letters, like, I don't know, like M or like B or D, I don't know. There's some letters that are just so beautiful. I definitely recommend getting that as kind of like your statement necklace. And because it is gold vermeil, you do have to take it off every single night. I will actually leave a picture that I posted on Instagram, and people went crazy over this picture. I think it actually looks so good together, so make sure you check that out. And I feel like this is that one necklace that everyone kind of needs as their statement necklace. Okay, so the next category I want to go into are rings, and I have a lot of rings this time round as well to share. This is what happens when I wait too long to do one of these videos. The first one that I want to share with you is the diamond dome ring, and this is what it looks like. So the diamond dome ring, it goes up like this and it has like all these diamonds on the side, and it just looks so, so good when you put it on. Unlike other rings, this one does have a little bit more dimension because it does kind of like curve upwards, whereas like most rings are pretty flat, but this one does kind of like give it a dimension. I don't know if you can tell from here, but you guys can see that it does like go upwards. This is different than the pavé diamond ring, and I will show you guys the difference. There are more diamonds in the diamond dome ring, and then whereas the pavé ring has less diamonds and it is a little bit flatter. I think it's gonna be your preference on which one you want, but as you guys can see, I am leveling up my diamond game, so I do have both and they all look really good. And honestly, they do look different. I definitely think if you are also like me and you're like, do I need two? The answer is yes, okay? Just always yes. But then again, I'm like a very bad enabler, so maybe I'm like not the best person to ask. Okay, the next ring that I have is actually a funny one because this is one of those rings, and I think I mentioned this in the favorites video, where when I first saw it, I was kind of just like, oh, like I don't know if it's gonna look good. It's like a weird concept, and let me tell you why. It is the chain ring, and on the website, they have two sizes. This is the thinner one. I do like the thinner one a little bit better because I do have smaller hands, and I do like the dainty look, but I always thought it was like weird looking when I like had looked at it on the website. As you guys can see, like when I hold it up, it's just literally a clump of gold and it's like very bendy. So I always thought that was weird, and I was like, would it slide off? But actually just the opposite. As you guys can see, when I put it on my hand, it's almost like tougher for me to put it on my finger. This is actually like really, really, really durable, and I absolutely love this ring. It's actually become one of my favorite rings on my fingers, which is so ironic considering it was like one of the rings where I always thought was like weird and I was like kind of turned off from. It's now like my favorite ring. Definitely recommend it. It looks like this when you put it on alone. It just looks so, so, so good. I can't even describe it. As usual, it is solid gold, so you never have to take it off. Third ring that I wanted to share with you guys is the duo ring. So this is the duo ring. I think both of the current must have Mejuri videos, I have put this on the wish list because I just feel like it's one of those those rings where it's for like the lazy person. If you are too lazy to stack and figure out how to stack on your own, this is just like such a great solution. But also when you wear it together, it actually has this like really intricate pattern and it just looks so good, kind of like twisted together, and it has like its own design that way. As you guys can see, I actually put it with my chain ring and this is what it looks like. Like I love the little crossover effect at the top. I like how it looks like I've really tried hard to layer, but really it's just two rings instead of three. It just makes this entire stack like super expensive looking and just like very dainty, and I just absolutely love it. And the last ring that I have to share with you guys is the Charlotte ring in solid gold. So initially when I got this ring, I was just like, oh my god, did I get the wrong one? Because I wanted the solid gold. It is quite thick. I do recommend the solid gold one just because I looked at the gold of Hermes and it looks really, really large. It looks kind of like it goes up a lot higher. So that's why I like the solid gold option. And obviously this way you don't have to take it off. I still kind of take this one off just because it is quite thick still, but I do really, really like the size of this one. And out of all my rings, this is the ring that I get the most questions on. Anytime I'm on my stories and I'm kind of like tapping onto something and showing people whatever it is, I feel like people completely disregard what I'm trying to show them. They're just like, where's that ring from? The one in your index finger. Even when I get my nails done, my nail ladies and like the people in the nail salon, they're like, oh my god, what ring is that? Send me a link, etc. I feel like this is like my most highly complimented one. I do know that it is a little bit on the pricey side, but if you are someone who is looking for like a statement piece, and also if you're looking for some people to be like, where did you get that damn ring? Then I don't know like what price you would put on that, but I personally think it's really worth it. But anyway, okay, so I wanted to move on to bracelets. So the bracelet that I have for you guys today is the, I'm just laughing because you guys are like, I think you're literally about to forget your name. The diamond initial bracelet. It just has the letter L on it and it is super dainty. Also, sidebar, I just want to say that I have this like really cute Casetify watch band as well, which also has the letter L on it. I don't know why I keep on getting these monogram products. The diamond initial bracelet is also solid gold, so you never have to take it off, and it just looks extremely, extremely dainty. I actually put it on the other hand because I already have two other solid gold bracelets from Majuri that I've mentioned in previous videos already. Obviously, I have my boyfriend bold chain. You guys know I love that style. This one is such a cute add, and I like it on the side of my watch. This actually happened all very coincidentally because it was just because I couldn't use my left hand to put it on my right wrist. So I ended up having to use my right hand to put it on my left wrist, and I really like the combination. So the last product that I have for you guys, I am saving the best for last. You guys actually inspired me to get this one, and if you follow me on Instagram, you already know what product I'm gonna tell you. It is the Boyfriend Bold Chain in the anklet version. I've already called it from earlier videos, but I was like, if the Boyfriend Bold Chain comes in an anklet, you know I'm gonna run to get it. From a previous video, you already know that I already have the other chain anklet. The two combined is something else. It just looks so good with number one, a tan. Also number two with heels. You look so, so expensive. If you guys have heard that thing where it's like, if you want to spot wealthy person shopping, you want to look at their like little accessories, like their watch or like their shoes or their sunglasses or whatever. I feel like having things like a gold anklet is like one of those things where it's so subtle. You might not notice it, but like if you have it and someone does notice it, it makes you look so expensive. Just like right off the bat adds like 50 points. You know, people have necklaces, people have earrings, but like anklets is just like another level, and it looks so cute. I will leave a little video here for you guys to see what it looks like on heels, but I can't even describe it. I'm gonna be wearing this all summer, and as usual, it is solid gold, so I never take it off. Okay, so enough about all the products that I have and love. Let's move on to the wish list, and hopefully you guys can also try out some of the products with me. I just have my old phone here. I'm just literally going through what my wish list is. Okay, so the first item that I have on my wish list is actually a jewelry box, because I feel like, as you guys can see, my collection is growing and I am just looking to store my jewelry a little bit more properly, safely, and just making sure that they keep their quality when I'm not wearing them all the time. But I do wear most of them most of the time. For some of the other necklaces, for example, I do want to store them properly. So the one that I have is the jewelry box, and I personally like it in the beige color because I feel like the aesthetic of my home is pretty soft toned. So I kind of like the beige color. So that's going to be the first one. I do have some other travel products from Mejuri. For example, I do have this leather case, which I absolutely love traveling with. It's just such a great, like, on the go one. So like I can put all my rings on here. I actually just recently came back, which is why it's unbuttoned. You can put all your earrings on here. Then you have this section where you could put all your necklaces. And what I love is that they have more pockets for you. Like there's one up here. The best part is that I like how this is actually more flat. It makes it easier to pack. Previously, when I first started with Mejuri, I had the small one and I outgrew this really, really quickly, which I still will use if I go on smaller trips. But as you guys remember, when I went back to Vancouver, I ended up going for 5 months. I needed a bigger travel case. So this was such a great travel case. So I really do like their leather products, but now I'm looking for something for the home and not something that's kind of like more in a bag and I always have to like zip it and stuff. That jewelry box is very, very appealing to me. I'll go through like one of each category because I will probably be trying some of these products in the next coming months. In terms of the earrings, the two items that I really, really want to try is actually the curved climbers because I feel like that's one category I've never really tried out. Last time when I tried the threaders for the first time, I didn't know how I was gonna feel about it, and it ended up being one of my favorite products of the year. Like not even the month, like of the year. For me, like I wanna try the climbers because I feel like it might be able to fill up more space in my ear while I'm waiting for my third piercing. And also just cause I don't know if I'm like ever gonna get cartilage piercing. I feel like this might be like a really good alternative. And the other one is the cuff. So I've tried a cuff before, but I wanted to try one from Mejuri. And this is another thing that just like will elevate the look that isn't just using your existing holes. And this also doesn't even require a piercing. I really want to try that one as well. Moving on to necklaces, I feel like my next big treat yourself product is going to be the large diamond necklace because I feel like after owning these smaller diamonds, I feel like my next level up is going to be the large one. I've actually seen a lot of people with the large diamond necklace from Mejuri, and I just feel like it looks super good on each person, and everyone tells me it's a great investment. I just want to join that club soon and, you know, have like a bigger diamond product. So moving on to rings, I actually have like 3 that I really want, even though my hands, I'm already running out of fingers. They need to start selling like toe rings at this point or something. So for the rings, my first one that I feel like is going to be kind of like priority for me is probably the snake ring. I've had my eye on that ring actually for a really, really long time now. I always thought it looked really badass and really just interesting. So I think that's gonna be like the priority on my list. So that's gonna be my ring one. I think I'm just gonna share one for now for the sake of the length of this video. The last category that I have for you is bracelets, and the wish list item that I have for my bracelets is the spheres bracelet. I feel like it looks so dainty, but the little detail is so cute. And I do have the spheres choker that looks really good. So I feel like on the wrist, it's also gonna look just as cute. So there you have it. That is pretty much my wish list for Mejuri and also all of my essentials so far. You guys definitely can look forward to another consolidated must-haves video soon. I hope you guys enjoyed this video and I will see you guys in the next one. Bye!